Hi everyone, I'm Cody, W3AMG with BridgeCom Systems, and today I'm going to be showing you how to add the NOAA weather channels to your radio. Same procedure is going to apply for both the handheld and the mobile. Super awesome and convenient thing to do if you live in an area with lots of storms or you just want to keep up with the weather. So first things first, go ahead and plug in the programming cable. Now you can add these from the front panel, but it will be easier to do from the CPS. So we're going to go ahead and plug in our radio here, just like that. Let's jump over into the computer. First thing I'm going to do is open up the correct CPS for my radio. Here we go. And you will want to read from your radio. So you just click on this read from radio button up here. I've already done that in this case, so we are good to go. Now, what I'm going to do is go to a web browser. And from here, we can see the different frequencies. Now, if you don't know how to find them, just do a Google search for them. NOAA weather channels, that'll be the first thing that pops up. And this will give you all of those different frequencies. Now, if you live in a different area, maybe not inside the US, just look for your local weather channels. If they have them, you should be able to find them online. So we have our information here. Now at this point, we're going to actually copy some of this down and go back to the software. So let's go ahead and create some channels. So just in the channel section, we'll create a channel in a blank spot. Now what I'm gonna do is just label these and give them a number, because each weather channel, typically it's 1 through 7. There's 7 of those channels, so we're gonna create all 7. Now the receive frequency is what we're interested in. We can leave the transmit blank, it won't make a difference. You wanna make sure to hit this PTT prohibit button. What that's going to do is stop your radio from actually transmitting on the frequency, which you would not wanna do. So in this case, we know we're looking for 162.400 for the first one. So we'll type that in here. 162.400. Now, go ahead and change this to analog. There you go. Transmit power is irrelevant because we don't have PTT. And at this point, you're pretty much set. That's all there is to it. So let's go ahead and go to the next one. So we'll label this once again. NOAA 2. Change it to analog. Hit the PTT prohibit. Then we'll go back over here, grab our frequency 162.425, and we're good to go there. Just go to next. So we'll go through all these real quick. Awesome, there we go. So once you have the last one done, just go ahead and click OK. And there we can see all of our 7 NOAA frequencies. So they are in our radio now. At this point, we would need to make a zone. So go over to zone, and let's just go ahead and make a zone here. We can call these NOAA, or obviously give it whatever name you'd like. If you'd rather name it weather, you could do that. And let's go ahead and scroll until we find them. If you added them to the bottom of your list, they will be at the bottom. In this case, ours are here. So just go ahead and click on one and use these arrow keys to add them over into your zone. There you go. Now you can select the default. So if you know the default for your area, you can have an A channel and a B channel. You can select those. In this case, we're just gonna leave that alone and click OK. Now at this point, we have a zone, so we can use these on our radio, but we can go a step further if we'd like and actually add them to a scan list. So here we go. I could create a new scan list. Open up a scan list here. Give it a name and go ahead and add these same channels to it. There you go. So we've added them. You can customize any settings you like and then click OK. And at this point, let's go ahead and write it to the radio. So go ahead and click write to radio, click OK, and write the other data. Awesome, there we go, it's complete. So let's wait for the radio to boot back up here. One thing to note about this, while this radio is booting up. The alert function does not currently work. Not a big deal. I've really never used it on these radios. They work great for tuning into the weather frequencies, but there is an option for it. So if you see that, the alert feature, it's not currently working. Maybe we'll see that in future software updates. Okay, awesome. Here we go. So we have the radio back up and running. We can use our zones to find that. There we go. There's the NOAA zone that we just added. So you can scroll through those channels. And because we have PTT prohibit checked, if we were to try to transmit on one, TX prohibit. So we can't actually accidentally transmit on the NOAA frequency, which would not be a good thing. So we're 100% prevented. Now at this point, if we wanted to access our scan list, if you have a button set up to scan, you can do that once we get to our list. So if we go into scan, you can go turn scan on. There you go. Obviously we have to select the list first. So we'll go to scan list and there's our NOAA list. Now here's a tip, if you have a long list especially, go ahead and click the up button. It'll take you down to the bottom and then you can click the select current list, select it. There we go, now it's selected. That's gonna be what's in our radio. So at this point, you can go ahead and turn scan on just like that. And it's gonna scan through. If we were outside, we'd actually see them. Now, if you want to make this faster and you plan on using it a lot, we have another video that shows you how to actually program custom function buttons so you can make one of these different buttons on your radio activate the scan list and turn it off.